Okay, students, now we are going to start about what are strings. What is a string? Okay, string are nothing but basically a bunch of characters or a collection of characters. Okay, a collection of characters or array of characters or a bunch of characters are known as what? String. Okay, if you want recording, you can just text me in WhatsApp. I will share you the link. Okay, because I can't give recording means permission to each and every one. So if you are so interested to repeat this session, you can ask me in WhatsApp. I will share you the link. Strings are generally a one dimension array of characters. Strings are nothing but one dimension array of characters. Here we have different ways of declaring a string. In R, we have different ways of declaring a string like we have in Python. Okay, we'll be seeing each and every way of declaring a string. First one, if you observe carefully, I declare a string within double quotes. It is a valid format. So see, if I run it comfortably, I'm getting OK1. Instead of double quotes, I'm going with single quotes. Okay, even single quotes is also valid. So either you give double quotes.
Why we are using cat?
Yeah. Okay. Why are we using cat? Cat is for what? Like concatenation. We are adding this string with the value present here. Understood, ma? In double quotes, this is a string, no? For this string, whatever value is present in str2, what are we assigning to str2? We are assigning OK2 to str2. That value we are printing here. So instead
sir,
of cat,
print we cannot.
Yeah,
know.
That's what I'm showing. Instead of cat,
sir, like print paste.
I'm doing the same thing.
Okay.
Sir. Yeah. So suppose I go with print. What will happen? We'll see. Understood? See, print is just throwing an error because this is a variable. Understood? It is not able to access the value inside that variable using print. Okay. Now, as you say, print and paste. Okay. Observe. Okay. Using print and paste together.
Sir,
we
doubt,
are able,
sir.
Yes, ma.
Sir, what is the difference between character and string, sir? Then both are same, sir. Declaring all that.
There is no difference between character and string in Python and R. In Python and R, there is no concept such as character. Everything is a string. When you talk about C, C++, Java, there is a difference between character and string. But here, there is no concept of character. Even if you in Python, if you declare a character and you try to, what is the type of, have used type of, then you will get it as a string, str. Remember? So there is no character concept either in Python or R. Everything is a string.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
See now, as your friend is now, cat and print paste, are they both same or different? Both outputs are
different,
both are different. Very good. Okay, print is again, it is converting everything into string and printing it on the screen. Okay, it is like a what? See here, one, it has given a one. Okay. So it is converting everything into string, but here it is not like, it is like a message. Okay. Observe the difference. Understood, ma? understood the difference between cat and print. That's how you go with cat. When I want to extract a value from a variable and print it as a message, then I go with cat. Okay. So either we can go with what, single quotes, or either we can go with double quotes. Now observe carefully. I have given starting with double quote, ending with double quote, starting with double quote, ending with double quote. In between, I am given some single quotes. Is it a valid format? Is it a valid format? Yes, it is a valid format. Now we'll run it. See here, I got the output. Now other way around, other way around. I'm starting with single quotes, ending with single quotes, starting with single quotes and ending with single quotes. In between, I have given double quotes. Is this a valid one? Yes, that is also valid one. So what is the rule you understood here? So whatever, either let it be single quotes or double quotes you are starting with, the same thing, with the same thing you should end with. Okay, if you are starting with double quotes, you should end with double quotes. If you start with single quotes, you should end with single quotes. And in between, you can use any number of opposite quotes. In between, you can use any number of opposite quotes. That means in this case, double quotes I am starting. So in between, I can give any number of single quotes. You should not throw an error. Okay, here also, I am starting and ending with single quotes. In between, I can use any number of double quotes. It will not throw an error. But what will happen if I start with single quotes, end with single quotes, in between also I give the single quotes. See, it is in comment. If I remove the comment, okay. Now, if you observe carefully here, everything is in green. From here to here, everything is in green. But here, only hi, comma is in green. This is in black. And it is clearly showing it is an error. It is clearly showing it is an error. If I run, also, it will give me errors only. If I run also, there is no end to that line. So, error only. I'm getting error only. Everything it is showing you has to be error. So, remember that. That is the reason I have marked this thing. I hope you are clear. You can start and end with the same thing. Okay, why it is error? Because see, this has mapped with this. Your friend is asking why it is an error. This single quote mapped with this. Okay, with whom will this map? There should be a mapping. No, string means what? String is something which is in between quotes. Let it be single quotes or double quotes. This has been mapped with this. What about this? Where are you ending this? Okay, that is the reason you get an error. Clearly it is showing, see, error is here. Control shift C. Okay, our next topic is length of string. Length of string. How to find length of string? To find length of string in R programming language, we have two ways. Okay. One way is using ncar function. One way is using what? Ncar function, which is an inbuilt function. Ncar function, which is a built-in function. And we have one more function, str underscore length. We have one more function, str underscore length, but it is not a generic function. It belongs to a package stringr. Understood? Str underscore length function is a function which is present inside a package, a stringr, which is present inside a package stringr. So before using this function, I should call this package. Okay. So what I'm doing, I'm importing that package. What is the name of the package? Stringr is the name of the package. And how do I import? I give library of stringr. I give library of stringr. Then imported successfully. Now I see what is the length of the string hello. So it should give me 5. Okay. It has given me 5 comfortably. Now, the same example, you try to use what? Ncar. Ncar is what? A inbuilt function. So no need to call any library or any package. Directly you can use NCAR of hello. Now the output should be 6 because even this single quote is also treated as a character because you are starting with double quotes, ending with double quotes. Now I run it, I got the answer 6. Okay. So these are the two ways of finding the length of a string in R programming language. Okay. Pin number 60 3060. See, instead of chatting me the questions, if you unmute and ask, it will be good so that even others will also know what is the question you are asking and what explanation I am giving. Is it fine, ma? Can you unmute and say okay?
Spaces also include now.
Yeah. Okay, you can ask me the questions so that others can also listen the question and they will also know the explanation. Okay, if for all the questions, if I give explanation without the questions, they won't understand. Okay. Okay, your friend is asking whether space are also treated. Tell me.
Yes, sir, definitely. Yes.
1, 2, 3 spaces I have given. Okay, 3 spaces I have given. Now I run it.
9.
Got. Okay, even space is also a character. It also has some ASCII value. Even tab space, everything is counted. Now we'll see how to access what portion of string, not complete string, portion of string. What do you mean by portion of string? Substring. I mean to say substring. Okay. To access a substring, we have a function substring, sub string. Okay. The shortcut of substring is what? Substr. So both are one and the same. Either you use substr or if you use substring, both refers to only the same function. Okay, there is no difference. So what is the syntax? Here I give the string. Okay, then I give the starting value and end value from where to where you want. Okay, this is the string I give, and then the starting value and the end value from where to where you want. Okay. Observe, I want substring from learn code tech 1, 3. Can you guess what is the output? First thing you should remember is in
LEA.
R, yes, very good. LEA, because in R the indexing starts from 1, not from 0. So it is 1, 2, 3. LEA is the output. Good. LEA is the output. Okay. So here, observe carefully. So I am assigning learn code to str, assign. Then using n character, I'm finding the length of learn code, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, 10. Good. Now tell me here what is the output for this one. STR is what? Your learn code. And what is length? 10, comma 10. Now tell me what can be the output. It's very easy. Very good. 10 is your last character. You are telling starting and ending be the same. So this is how, this is how you extract the last character. Okay, E. Now here tell me what will be the output. I am going out of index. So I have only 10 characters, but I am trying to access what? The 11th element. Okay. Here we don't get NA, but instead of that, we'll get an empty string. Okay, we get an empty string. If you try to access the same thing in C, C++, Java, you get a garbage value. If you try to access the same thing, okay, in other languages like C, C++, Java, you get a garbage value. But here, you don't get NA, you get an empty string. Okay. And the explanation is given here. You can go through it. Very good. Same thing. Okay. Again, this, I found the length of character. Okay, 1, 2, 4. As already you said, you get LEAR. Now here, tell me what is output. Your string is length code. Okay, length is your 10. 10 minus 2 is what? 8. 8 to 10. So what is output here? You get? Is it ODE or DE? You get? Yes. OD from 8, no? Length is 10. 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 to 10. So 8, 9, 10. So you get ODE as an output. Next topic is what? Case conversion. Case conversion means converting a string from, okay, lowercase to, you can convert a string into lowercase or into a uppercase. Here we are having three functions, okay, but we rarely use this. I'll tell you why. Okay, I have a code here which has combination of what? Upper and lower cases. Okay, so to convert a string into uppercase, I have a function to upper. Same wise, if you want to convert a string into lowercase, you have a function to lower. See here, to upper is converting everything into upper, to lower is converting everything into lower. Okay, now what does case fold do? Case fold will convert everything into lower. Case fold will convert the string into lower. It is similar to lower. Case fold is similar to what? Converting a string into lower. But using case fold, if you want to convert a string into upper, then you should pass one argument, that is upper equal to true. So by default, what is happening? By default, upper equal to false is there. So it is converting into.
Sir, doubt, sir.
Oh, 1 second, I'll finish. But upper equal to true is what? It is converting into uppercase. And there is no use of this mark. Okay. If you want to convert to upper, we directly use this. And if you want to convert lower, we'll use lower directly. Okay. It is just for confusion. Yes, ma'am. What is your doubt?
Sir, their high is missing now, sir. High length of coding.
Okay. Oh, sorry. I did not run this. That was the previous thing. Okay.
Okay, sir.
The previous what I have assigned, I directly used it. Clear, ma? So there is no use, yes, of sir. This case fold. We go either way, go with what? To for lower, you directly do lower. Upper is to upper. Next topic is what? Updating string. Next is what? Updating a string. This is a little, it can be a little tricky one. Okay. To update a string, first you should be able to access the string. Okay. So accessing is very easy. We'll go with an example. And you try to tell me what is this? What type is str here? Observe the input and tell me what type is str.
Vector.
Very good. It is a vector, not a string. Okay. It is a vector of strings. Okay, it is a vector of string because I'm using C combine function. So I have taken four different strings. Okay, I'm combining it and storing in str. That means it is a vector of strings. Very good. So str I print. So I got this. Now here tell me what will happen if I use this substring of str of 2,2 equal to percentage. Run this now. Tell me what will be the output. Yes, it
with
WI.
No, first you tell me about this. What is this? It is for every string starting with 2, ending with 2. That means what in program? What is 2,2? In program, R. Very good. In program, 2,2 is R. In width, what is 2,2? I. In new, what is 2,2? E. In A. Language, what is A? So wherever you are giving position, that position you should replace with percentage. This is not a string. This is a vector. So what is the output? Okay, from str, it is picking up first string. Here, okay, it is repeating a loop inside. Okay, it is repeating a loop. Okay, it is taking program. 2,2 replacing with percentage. Then it is taking with 2,2 replacing with percentage. And taking new percentage. Taking language percentage. Clear, ma? This does not mean this I. Okay? This means you are picking up one single character. Clear with this point? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me here what will happen. Yes, tell me what will happen.
Third character of every character is a dollar.
Where third character of every string is dollar. Okay, PRO dollar, WI dollar, NE dollar, this dollar. This was pretty simple. I want you to answer this one. What is the difference between previous one and this one? For replacing also I have given a vector. For replacement also I have given a vector. This all itself is a vector. I'm trying to replace that characters with one more vector. Can you see the output? What is 3,3 third character? O
percentage and at the rate will be there.
Yes, I think this is clear. Substring 3,3 means what? Third character H, W, third character N. So here what happens is first time
percentage.
Yes, second time it will be at the rate. First I run it. I take str. Then I run it. Then I print str. Okay. First time this is replaced here. This is replaced here. Okay. Next, this understood more alternatively. Okay. First, this will get replaced. Next, this will get replaced. Okay. This will get replaced. Clear ma? What has happened? Alternately, replacement is being happened. First time percentage, at the rate percentage, at the rate, because this is also a vector. Clear ma? Any dots, ma? Any dots in strings? Yes, no. Okay, today many of you have responded. I'm very happy for it. Okay, there is one more last topic left in data structure, that is arrays. Okay, I have uploaded array strings, everything in Moodle. Okay, what you can do is you can go through this array and you can execute and you can read everything already, means not everything, initially basic introduction I have already given. Okay, while creating array, you should give number of rows, number of columns, and then you can names and everything. You please go through this, execute this, and I'll create an assignment on array that you have to upload. Okay. I think half an hour is more than enough. Is it clear, ma? Yes, because I have invitation now. Okay. You please finish it off. If you have any doubt, I'll clarify that in next class.
Okay.
Okay, now this you can download from Moodle, ma. You try to run and see whatever the, okay. Already it is like combination of matrix and arrays. Arrays and matrix we have called, no? Sorry, not arrays, sorry. List and matrix, okay. It is like combination of list and matrix and everything is very straightforward and simple. Okay. You try to finish it off in this half an hour. Okay, students, please. Okay, we'll meet in next class.